Yo, everybody, Star here. What is going on? Today, I've got something pretty interesting for you guys. This is the Hidden mod for Team Fortress 2, and if you've never heard of the Hidden before, it is a mod for Half-Life 2, which pits one player who is almost completely invisible at all times against an entire team of people who are trying to kill him, or capture him, or whatever, and that is this mod built into Team Fortress 2. It's a lot like Saxton Hale, if you're familiar with that, except you're not a muscular Australian, you're just a spy who is infinitely invisible. The only time you're not invisible is if you dash or you backstab somebody, which, by the way, you can dash around the map by pressing the secondary attack button, which this is my very first time playing as the spy in this mode, so I didn't really exactly know what I was doing. I think I do pretty well for my first time playing it. And there also is a ability to fear or bonk everybody in a small radius around you, which I didn't know how to do, which you can do with the reload button. Unfortunately, I had no idea how to do that this run, and I'm gonna be taking down Salamancer in a second in a spot which I told him was going to be the perfect impervious spot to spies.
What?
Dude, you're not supposed to be able to get me there. I thought that was a perfect spot, Star.
Ho-ho, deception as a spy. I told you it was a good spot because I knew I'd be able to backstab you there. I didn't know that. I mean, that's a pretty good spot if you just keep your back to the wall the whole time. You're going to be really bored, but you're not going to get backstabbed. But anyway, easily the best thing about this game mode is if you're playing with people and you get to hear their reaction to you stabbing them. Every time, it's funny. You just want to hear them be upset because they feel so safe. They're in that perfect spot. There's no way this invisible guy could backstab me, could he? Yeah, he probably can if he does something clever enough or it gets you at the exact right moment. And those moments, they're so good, especially when you can hear the people. I love it. Anyway, one thing that's definitely worth mentioning here is that this game mode is still in development. And a good example here is that pyros are built for spy checking. It is not fun to play the hidden spy guy against pyros. They can't light you on fire, but it's just so easy for them to check everywhere and you to, like, it's such a struggle to try and get behind them. Compared to the Half-Life 2 mod of the hidden, nobody has flamethrowers. They've just got regular guns. It's hard to kill the hidden. He has much less life, but if you get a shot on him, it's a good job by you. And in this, it's just a little bit more wonky because it isn't fully complete. And Pyro is a good example because after this map, which we played here, Pyro was disabled. No one could play it anymore. Which, thank you, by the way. That was not, it's not fun, okay? Another good example is that snipers are allowed to wear the Razorback in these gameplays. I'm sure it's not going to stay that way because that was also pretty annoying. But yeah, snipers and Razorbacks. At the moment, it's still really fun, but there are some flaws that are just, like, worth noting for this, where, I mean, if you get everybody into a tiny little room, put a dispenser down, and have a heavy just shoot at the doorway infinitely with his minigun, what do you honestly think that the spy is going to be able to do against that? Not really anything. All he has is the ability to stun people, and to backstab people, and to dash around. Dashing doesn't help you in a small hallway. Backstabbing, even if you stun the person, they could just keep their back to the wall if they're a heavy and, you know, not die to it. In the official hidden mod, the player has grenades to throw. If people camp up like that and they're just trying to hold one tiny spot and be really boring like that, you could just toss a grenade in there and have them all scatter. I'm pretty sure as well, not 100%, but I think in the hidden, if you stab somebody in the face, even in the face, it's a one-shot kill. In this, it's still gonna take like 1,000 swipes to kill a heavy. Especially if he's being healed by a medic, there's a lot of classes and a lot more items to account for which are currently allowed, and a lot more silly things that can happen in here. So the balance obviously isn't as good as the official hidden mod. I mean, that game has been around a while. People have had time to balance it. The game was made just for that. All I'm saying, though, is that there's a lot of potential in this. One more thing worth noting is that if the spy doesn't backstab people within a certain amount of time, he just dies. Like, if you're just hiding in a corner, cloak and daggering, wasting everyone's time, you will eventually just, like, bleed out and be dead, which is fantastic. Alright, everybody, we're gonna be doing a live commentary for this one, trying to get the backstabs. I don't know if it's gonna go so well, because everybody, every time I'm the spy, they all hide in one room. It's pretty difficult to win this game mode. I mean, if the enemy team, if all those dudes really, 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 really try, it's pretty, whoa, what the, what? I would have had him. I'll take the heavy. I'm fine with that. I don't know where the scout went, trying to look through walls for him. But see, they're all going to be on this midpoint. There's some even, like, worse rooms they can hide in on this map that it's just like, how are you supposed to do anything? So what we're going to do, what I believe needs to be done, Before one, let's get rid of his Razorback. Because, yeah, Razorback actually works in this, which is kind of weird. Now I've got people up in that room. Maybe I could pull something ultra sneaky here. Oh, no, that didn't work. You, Demo Man, you're out here alone. I don't know what you're doing, aggro. All of here by yourself. I don't know. Going swimming, something. Not gonna stick around there, I'll tell you that much. As soon as somebody, like... Oh my god. As soon as you stab somebody or as soon as people spot you, they all come out of their hiding places because they want to get damaged because they have to kill you. Because if they kill you, then they get to be the one who plays next. Totally fair. Totally fair. That's why you don't want to be on your own. Because then I could just do something silly like that. And that was pretty funny that he's just walking around the corner at the perfect time. There we go.
Come here, Star. Come on. Oh, you're no fun.
Oh, wait.
You don't want to be by yourself. We get a couple more stabs, get our health back up, that would be fantastic. There's one down. People just get bored. You know what it is? Just sitting around waiting to get killed. I mean, I would get bored too. Dinkelberg getting a little bored. It's better off I just get out of here. He's a little bit too smart to walk around that corner. Not gonna happen, but people are gonna come out now. And we're out. We're very low on the health. Still 7 people to kill. Who's this over here? Who's this that wants to die? Just swinging a pickaxe. He hit me too! Rusky dude, just bored. I don't wanna live no more. There you do. We can get rid of your Razorback while you're being the decoy. Maybe not. I think if you dash, like while you're in the dash or at the start of the dash, it seems like you just can't get backstabs from doing that. But I should probably take my time here. There's no way I'm gonna be able to kill all these people in here. They still have like an Uber charge, they're just shooting at doorways. Huh. Is there like a ceiling in here I can stand on? No. My foot's falling asleep! There's no one anywhere else on the map. You, if I'm gonna get anyone... It's gonna be no one. Nope! Alright guys, I've got one more for you. This one should be a little bit more interesting. I suppose of all the arena maps, the stock arena maps that this server is playing, Watchtower kind of seems like it would be one of the most balanced ones for actually getting stabs. Which, oh, I'm very disappointed I didn't get that here. Come get some. Yeah! It's not like he even knows I'm there. It's not like I'm leading him into anything. It's just... Yeah, okay, well. Watchtower's got a lot of open space. That's the good part. It's got a lot of high ground, too, which... I'm sorry, I'm a little bit distracted. There's a lot of stuff going on right now. Let me try and sneak. Yeah! Peace out, peace out. So you have all these people who are naturally going to hide around the control point like they were last time, but one benefit that you have this time, which I'd like to see how this works. Oh my god, are you kidding me? The luck on that man right there. Buy a lottery ticket, except don't. You're probably going to waste your money. So what I want to do is get on that roof, and there are holes in the roof that I can drop down through. this gentleman.
Oh.
You're down.
No. Well played.
Every single person in this corner up on the cabinets. Oh god, is there anyone else on this entire map anywhere else? This is what it boils down to. I missed really bad. But I guess he wants to die. Who cares that you have Uber? Could just do that to you. You get your boo meter, which is filling up on the screen right now, pretty quickly. So that's really not something that you need to worry about. See, I almost have it at 75%. I could probably kill this scout solo if I can build it up and just jump on him. We're gonna do that. Yep. That really is, like, so cheap of an ability. I feel bad doing that to people. I'd rather have something that, like, pulls people's backs off of corners, but whatever. No! I'm gonna get you. At least I got him. So we're gonna try and come through the roof finally, see if we can possibly get on these people. We have the scare capabilities. You know what, that's not gonna work. There's like no good angle to get on their heads. Like, if I'm gonna jump in here, I just wanna get on top of the medic. Let's wait till this Uber finishes. I don't know why they're using it. Oh, that was so lucky! That was so lucky! Oh my god, we're in there! We got this. We're gonna be able to take down the rest of these people, no problem. See if we can jump that high. No. No. Oh, we fell. So if I just single these people out one by one, this is gonna be no problem whatsoever. Engineer's jumping around like a Looney Tune. No big deal. There we go. My boy. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this look at the Team Fortress 2 Hidden mod. I had a lot of fun. I really do enjoy it a lot more than I have any other Saxton Hale variant. It's just, you never know where he's gonna pop up, and when you actually do get to play as a spy, it's so much fun to stab people. Worth pointing out too, currently, the person who kills the spy becomes the spy next, so there is incentive to go out and hunt him down. If I could summarize how I feel about this game mode really quickly, and just like one simple thought of what I think would make it a lot better is if the spy was much more powerful and died much more quickly. If you make one mistake, you're probably gonna die from it, and if somebody has their back to a wall and they're just being silly, you can deal with them no problem. You could just go up to them, kill them, make your way out, but if somebody catches you, you're dead. Spy would die faster, rounds would end faster, you'd kill people faster all around. I think that would be much better, but that's just my personal opinion. Hope you guys did enjoy this video, and peace out, everybody. Catch you guys for the next one.
Oh, Star, you face-stabbing facey face.
There's a backstab on my screen.
Yeah. But I'm trapped down
here.
Oh,
no, what? It's not fair, bro.
If only you could crew jump, Rusky.